Remember that the pi system of the six-membered heteroaromatic ring is electron deficient. In other words, it has a very low-lying LUMO, and a low-lying LUMO means that it's accessible to nucleophilic attack. In other words, the pi system, pi star in particular, can serve as an electron acceptor or an electrophile. And we're going to see that mode of reactivity here. So let's take pyridine, where we're going to do a substitution reaction on the 4 position. We've got a good leaving group in the 4 position, chlorine atom, and we've got a nucleophilic source in the methoxide group. The methoxide ultimately displaces that chlorine atom, and it does so by a nucleophilic attack. We would consider this step as a nucleophilic attack that involves nucleophile addition to a polarized pi bond, which we recognize as the AD sub N step. And we can do that because that pi star is low-lying, since we're dealing with an electron-deficient aromatic ring. This creates a tetrahedral intermediate. A tetrahedral intermediate undergoes a beta elimination. The E-beta step displaces the best leaving group, which is the weakest base, and that's chloride. And so the net result is a substitution reaction through the addition-elimination sequence that we've seen before. That's how we do substitution at sp2 carbon atoms. It turns out that we can really accelerate this reaction by making that ring even more electron deficient and putting formal positive charge in the ring if we alkylate that nitrogen by the ways that we've learned in previous webcasts. We can make that LUMO even lower in energy and that electrophile even more potent of an electrophile. We can make the reactivity a billion times faster simply by making that ring positively charged. It becomes a very good electron sink relative to pyridine. Here we can think about a mechanism for this reaction in which that nitrogen ring, that heteroaromatic ring, is going to serve as an activating agent for coupling the alcohol, ethanol, to the molecule of benzoic acid. And how does that get involved under base-catalyzed conditions? This ring is a stoichiometric reagent. We need a stoichiometric amount of it. It's not a catalyst. And we want to know what the mechanism is which generates this functionality over here that's known as the pyridinone. So basically you can see that our heteroaromatic underwent a kind of substitution, bromine for oxygen, on the ring, and we've lost HBr, making the new bond there. How does all that take place? Well, the mode of reactivity looks like this. It's a nucleophile addition to a polarized pi bond. We could write this as a general base. It's not written very well here, but it could be written as a general base catalyzed process, where triethylamine comes in, deprotonates that hydrogen atom, making it nucleophilic. That oxygen does a nucleophilic attack to a polarized pi bond and adds into the aromatic ring. The beta elimination step follows with the lone pair on nitrogen. We kick out the bromine from this tetrahedral intermediate through a beta elimination, and now we have a very good leaving group. So this carbon-oxygen double bond, its pi system is activated because we have in that heteroaromatic a very good leaving group that will ultimately generate the pyridinone, a very stable heteroaromatic ring. So the oxygen of ethanol is a nucleophile, and I'm only showing you very briefly the mechanism. It's outlined not in all detail, but just by now you should know the nucleophile addition generates a tetrahedral intermediate that does a beta elimination to give us a new substitution reaction, a substitution reaction in which we've substituted all of the atoms that are shown here with the oxygen atom of ethanol. All of that's possible, that's made possible because of the nucleophilic attack at the pyridinium bromide on this activated heteroaromatic ring toward a nucleophilic attack. We see this mode of reactivity in biological systems. NAD+, for example, undergoes nucleophilic attack at the 4 position with the nucleophilic source of hydride anion, and that generates the intermediate NADH, the reduced form, in which that nucleophile adds in to that heteroaromatic ring because of its mode of reactivity as an electrophile. We can see that in the lab as well. Here's a chemically related analog where the hydride source is a boron hydride. You can think about this as just a resonance contributor where there's H minus and neutral boron, and that H minus is a nucleophile that adds in to that 4 position. That generates this, what we call dihydropyridine. It's a non-aromatic ring system, and it looks very much like the NADH molecule.